I think I've said this before, but the easiest way to my heart musically is luscious strings, amazing arrangements, incredible, immaculate performances, great singing, great songwriting, really nothing too like extreme or incredibly out of the ordinary. That's at least one way to get to my heart. And for Chloe, I'm gonna just refer to her as Chloe in this review because I cannot pronounce anything in French, but for Chloe, she has the right formula. She knows what to do to at least get to me. Diving into her background, she is a Canadian musician specializing in art pop, baroque pop, progressive pop, singer-songwriter music too. She's also worked with chamber folk and pop as well, and that's no different on this new album over here, which is a follow-up to her 2016 album, one of which I cannot pronounce to save my life. Her debut album came out in 2013, which showed a lot of potential, a lot of great qualities of that record. However, I think this new album, she has really grown into her own. I think this is her most fully realized work yet. This album is 12 tracks and 42 minutes, which on first listen I was kind of surprised by. I was like, wow, this album feels a lot longer and more intricate than it actually is. It is a vast array of horns, trombones, strings, and violins, and violas, and pianos, and drums. It has this lush orchestral presentation that feels larger than life. It also has a singer that can portray vocally a larger than life performance. On this record, it kind of sounds like Chloe is like in a life or death situation. I know it's not that eager, but it just sounds like that sometimes. This album is bookended by two title tracks, which are nothing more than an introduction track and a song that kind of fizzles us out on the album, which for the most part I think are really good. I think the opening track really showcases what's to come on this record. It's more or less like a palate cleanser rather than a taste tester. It's saying, get rid of whatever you just heard of because you're going to experience something that is almost unlike anything you've heard in your life. And the final track of this album is more or less just a thank you for coming, hope to see you again soon kind of song. However, the middle portion of this album, from track 2 to track 11, has some of the most luscious, dense, layered, and immaculate songs I've heard in a while. And in a lot of respects, this album is somewhat symmetrical. It sounds like the first couple of tracks are similar to the last couple of songs. The way the second track builds into this grand finale, and the way the penultimate track of this album is a grand finale, with reverb pianos and orchestral string arrangements that are ornate and lovely to the ears, horns and vocals and lyrics that are just calling out into oblivion. This final moment of this album is not only the greatest finality of record I've heard this year thus far, but it is easily the best song on this record. But it's not by a mile, because some of the songs on this album are fantastic. Jumping back to the second track of this album, the opening moments of the song has a very jaunty and upbeat indie pop sound. Vocally, Chloe is frolicking and prancing across the sea of drums. Guitars are then introduced into the track very subtly, but they're noticeable. Then the song kind of transitions to this grimmer and almost darker sound, with some very heavy bass trombones that are playing underneath Chloe's vocals that are calling out into the ether. It sounds like she's stretching her voice out to be as long and as proud as possible. The ending of the song kind of takes these two elements of the track and kind of puts them together to create a upbeat, sad, and deep song that really hits to the core. An amazing way to open this album. The track Umami does a very similar thing as well. Don't need to talk about this track too much. The vocals again are frolicking across its instrumental. Chloe is stellar on this track. I mean, Chloe really shines on every track she's on vocally. She does an amazing job at putting together some heart-wrenching vocal performances. And vocal performances that can be happy, a little bit upbeat, a little bit jaunty, very almost smile-inducing, very pristine, very pretty, just like a lot of the instrumentals on this album. And while for the most part on this album you're getting some very organic strings and horns that are playing across this entire record, you also get some synthesizers that work their way into some of these tracks. Like the track Melamine, which is probably the closest thing to a pop song this album has to offer. Like a genuine pop song, not like an art pop or a baroque pop song, because yes, all of these songs are pretty much baroque pop, but this is the closest this album has to a genuine radio-friendly pop song. The hook is there, it's catchy, it's infectious. Its instrumental is grand, larger than life, and danceable. It's groovy at points. You get backing vocals, you get some little tidbits of instrumentation like a hi-hat and a little bit of a synthesizer in the background too. The fifth track also includes synthesizers that are worked into the beginning of the song. They're a little warped and they do that kind of thing. There are also some moments on this record where simplicity works to Chloe's benefit, like on the eighth track for Elise. While structurally this song is pretty simplistic, there are some musical embellishments that make this song stand out. That doesn't necessarily happen for the track La Fanta, which isn't a bad song, definitely not, but it's definitely one of the more mild moments on this album. It's certainly a song that is memorable, no doubt. But the performance on this track in particular is definitely toned down compared to the rest of this album. I just kind of wanted a little more. That's also true for tracks 4 and 7 on this album. I think structurally these songs are great, but sound-wise they could have been a little bit more ambitious. And I find that some points on this record, the songwriting could be a little repetitive, at least for my liking, and I am gonna tell you that I don't understand French, and you know, French isn't even like a language that I've studied at all. But I will say, I can't envision this album being sung in English. Like, I cannot envision that whatsoever. And I don't listen to a lot of French music, so I'm not too entirely sure of the songwriting styles that are in that language. However, I will say, this album is great. This album is spectacular in a lot of great ways. Whether it's for how well these baroque pop and art pop ideas come together on this record, for how luscious and beautiful and just larger than life this album feels. At its best moments, there are some grim orchestral-sized tracks that feel like they're enveloping your soul and you just are being lifted towards the heavens. Other tracks where it feels like Chloe is singing to you personally. In some way, this album flexes its muscles for how it can compose, write, structure, and perform these songs and make them sound so amazing, larger than life, but still sound very natural and wonderfully organic. Even if I wanted more in the songwriting department, and even if some tracks didn't stand out to me as being super stellar, the highlights on this record are incredibly high. All I'm really asking for next time around is kind of a longer album experience because I'm greedy. But because this record is so damn gorgeous, so beautiful, so enchanting, so whimsical, so breathtaking, it is rare that an album makes me breathless, makes me just flabbergasted. And when it does, it sticks with me throughout the year. The songs also come together in such an amazing way, like it doesn't feel like one song is completely disconnected from another. The ninth track is probably the song that feels the most different and most out of place on this record, but they all come together in such a wonderful and forgivable way. It's a mistake that I just can forgive, right? And you know, some of my favorite albums don't have the best and most amazing flow whatsoever. Beggars can't be choosers. You gotta pick and choose your battles. And for me personally, this is an album that I just cannot say no to for the most part. I'm impressed. I can't wait to see where Chloe can go from here. Personally, I'm gonna give this album a very strong A-. However, I am curious to know what are your thoughts and opinions on this album down below. Let me know what albums you want me to review next, and that is it. Leave a like, comment, share, do whatever you want. Let me know how I can improve future videos down below. Remember, it's only my opinion, because music is subjective.